In video, audio is the one thing that makes the biggest difference. It's the first indicator that a film doesn't have enough budget or a video is done at home is audio like this. All I have is bare flat walls, and these walls reflect sound really well. I'm using a lav, I'm using a professional camera. It sounds awful. And so what we're going to do is put some things on the walls to try to absorb sound instead of reflecting it, so it doesn't just become a big echo.
I sketched up ideas and consulted with friends who are sound pros in the music and movie industries, and we settled on a wall treatment and a ceiling treatment. The materials I decided to use are a mix of professional and DIY. Ignore the wood, I didn't end up needing that. The furniture blankets are our baffles for the ceiling, and I used the packing material that the rest of our acoustic treatment came in to fill the baffles. And for the walls, we used a Prime Acoustic London 12 kit that comes with 8 1x4 panels, 12 1x1 panels they call scatter blocks, and 2 2x4 panels that are called bass traps. The normal setup for a system like this is to create what's called a live end dead end room, where one side of the room absorbs more sound than the other. Though our video projects need a little less reverb, so I use these panels in a different configuration. First, I plan the placement of the baffles to stagger across the ceiling, and use a laser measure to mark the spot for my hooks. Then I punched grommets into the corners of the blankets, and hung them. This made them easy to remove if we want to change the soundscape. Next, I installed the acoustic panels so they cover the room. Have a listen to how the acoustics of the room changed along the way. Next is the window. Because there's so much outside noise here in Brooklyn, I tried to do something to deaden that. We constructed a panel from doubled up furniture blanket material. Then we added heavy velour stage curtains. I devised a system that allows me to lift the blankets off the window when we aren't recording. Now let's hear the difference this all made in the sound of the room. Remember, this is how it sounded before.
We just moved into new offices, and today I'm setting up the acoustic treatment for.
And here's how it sounds now.
So I'm here with Mike Infante. Mike is a professional audio technician, and he's gonna help us go over some of the more advanced techniques.
Ideally, you wanna get the mic as close as you can to the subject without getting in the shot.
How amazing is that? So I can craft the sound in this room by adding or removing panels and add a little bit reverb if I want. Also, this cost us about $1,500 all told. You can get a lot less than that by going with an all DIY solution if you want, but if your acoustic treatment's gonna be in the shot like it is behind me, you might want something a little more professional. Make sure to watch our other videos in our how-to video series for more tips. Thanks for watching.